Blackstone presents New Rules for War by Michael Anderle. This book is read by Sarah Mollo-Christensen. Dedication. Remembering Judah Rain. Judah was a very strong advocate for The Zoo, a sci-fi universe created by Michael Anderle. Why travel to a distant star system when you can visit an alien jungle here on Earth? Judah took it upon herself to create an author's guide to help new authors to The Zoo get up to speed quickly. She enlisted several readers to help create the author guide, what she ultimately referred to as the Zooclopedia Tyrannica. It truly was a monster spreadsheet, which was appropriate for all of the alien mutant monsters that roamed the zoo. We had a lot of fun creating mutant hybrid monsters and coming up with crazy names for them. Since the zoo was surrounded by militaries from a number of different countries, we needed to research what military hardware and weapons each country would use to make the stories realistic. We're pretty sure that researching all the different weapons got us listed on at least one NSA watch list, or three. Besides being a reference for new zoo authors, Judah also played a key role in creating new stories for several very popular zoo series. She made the stories fast-paced, entertaining, and fun. Those books were always popular with our JIT proofreading group. Hashing out zoo storylines, mutant alien monsters, and technology was a lively affair, generating lengthy online discussions. Due to the time differences, those discussions usually didn't start until after 10 p.m. Eastern Time and could last until 1 or 2 a.m. After a while, my wife made me mute the channel so she could sleep. I guess that was better than her telling me to go to another room. Judah always showed her compassion, wit, and sharp intellect during our discussions. She challenged us, grounded us, and supported us so we could help the new authors and help make the zoo stories the most entertaining and fun stories they could be. I'll never forget our late-night discussions, Judah's compassion, drive, and wit, and our zoo family that grew out of our common interest in this sci-fi universe. She will be missed. Written by John Ashmore, a valued member of the LMBPN Beta and JIT teams. Chapter 1.
You're still jerking the suit around. Up the sensitivity and get used to it moving at almost the same reaction time as the rest of your body.
Cortez approached and tried to yank out a piece of carapace that had gotten stuck in one of the joints.
The way you're doing it, you always push too hard to overcompensate for how slow it's reacting. Then the suit drags you off balance.
The chunk finally came out, and Chill scowled as she watched Cortez pick off bits and pieces she'd missed. He was coddling her, and the most annoying part was that his coordination allowed him to pick those pieces off without so much as nudging her in the back.
Right, right. I get it. You're a parent, and you want to be a parent to everyone on the team.
She's more cantankerous than usual,
Zychix pointed out from his spot inside Cortez's suit.
Was it something you said or did? Maybe we can find a way to appease her when we get back to the ship.
No, that's not necessary.
Chill had vivid memories of the last time Zychix had tried to appease her when she was in a bad mood. The gesture had been appreciated, but clearing the synth roses out of her cabin had been a fucking nightmare.
Just frustrated by having to deal with these suits, is all. Seems like everyone else is picking up on how to use them better than I am.
It's quite all right.
The little alien sounded like he was rummaging through the suit as he spoke.
Ivan has been dealing with similar frustrations, although he does benefit from being able to keep himself well removed from the fighting.
I do not,
Ivan interjected over their shared calm.
My superior grasp of how these suits work simply lets me be more on top of things. Besides, shooting and hitting them with my knives doesn't require me to be very close to the fighting.
Pretty sure that's what the little guy said.
Chill shook her head.
Enough talk.
But enough talk. For now.
There was no need to hear Ivan's extensive ruminations on how they were running the op. They had to keep on moving through the tunnels if they were going to get the job done. So if he wanted to talk, it had to be...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.